So next we'll see slices. So that I have told, slices means part of the array. So that is called as slices. Now see, we'll talk about Python programming language. So see, we'll take this. So this is the list. We'll copy this. I will check in Python. Now see. Okay, so this is a list we have defined here. Now see, if I take vector 3:6, so I am taking part of this list or array. So see, when I take vector 3:6, so what I am getting? This. So see, 8, 10, 12. So see, from third index, so see, it will have 0, 1, 2, 3. So third index 0, 1, 2, 3. So starting from third index, I am getting the values. And 6, so 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. 14. 6 is the 14, but 14 is not there. So before 6 means what values will be there? Index 3, index 4, index 5. Just before 6, these values will be there. Now see, we can also provide like this. So see, what values we are getting here? Vector 0:7:2. Now see, what is the value answer that we are getting? So see, 0 index in the sense 2. So from second we will get it. So see, 7 means 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. So 7 is 16. So before that means up to 14 we are getting the result. Okay, so from 2 to 14, but not all values we are getting. We are not getting all values from 2 to 14. So we have mentioned third parameter, that is 2. So every second element is getting printed. So see, starting from 2, then second element is 6. So 6 we got. Then second element is 10. So 10 we got. And again after that second element 14. So that we got. If instead of 2, if we mention 1. So we'll get all these values. So in this way we can have a slices. Then how the array types are implemented or how address is calculated. Now look at this. So how address is calculated for this. So suppose lower index is 0 and we have to find out address of kth element. So how address will be calculated? So address of the 0th element plus k into k means this k index variable or element we have to find out the address into element size, means size of every element. So like this we can find out the address of the any element. So but here we are considered 0 as a lower bound first element in any array. Now if we have to generalize this, so formula can be like this. So see how we got the formula. So here in this example we have considered 0 as a lower bound. So if we generalize it, so we will take this lower bound, then we have to find out address of kth element. So here instead of k, we will mention k minus lower bound, and then element size. So element size, so based on that, so if it is integer, 2 bytes, float, 4 bytes, like that. In this way we are calculating the address of any element. Now see, there is one more concept, row measure order and column measure order. What do you mean by that? So see, this is a 3x3 matrix. Okay, so we can say it is a multi-dimensional matrix of size 3x3, 3 rows and 3 columns. So see, in programming languages, in many programming languages, how this multi-dimensional matrix or multi-dimensional array is saved in memory. So 3 is saved, then 4 is saved, then 7 is saved. After that 6, 2, 5, 1, 3 and 8. So we are saving in this way. 3, 4, 7, 6, 2, 5, 1, 3, 8. So this is called as a row measure order. So almost in many programming languages, elements are saved in row measure order. Like this. These elements are saved. After that these elements are saved. And after that these elements are saved. Another is column measure order. So what do we column measure order like this? If elements are saved like this, 3, 6, 1, after that 4, 2, 3, after that 7, 5, 8. If elements are saved in this order, so then it is called as a column measure order. Keep in mind, Fortran programming language, it supports column measure order. This means in a Fortran programming language, elements are saved in column measure order. Column wise, elements are saved column wise. Then see, we'll talk about the descriptor. So what by descriptor? So collection of all the attributes is called as the descriptor. So see, we are talking about a single dimension array. So see, what values will be there in descriptor? Descriptor means collection of attributes or properties. So see, this is single dimension array. Element type means whether what is the type of the array, whether it is an integer, float, character, or whatever it is. The index type. So what is the type of indices? So normally it is integers. So we have the integers. Normally we use integers as the indices. But in some programming language that we have seen in ADA programming language, we can have a boolean, character, or enumeration type as the indices. So it depends on the programming language. But normally we have integers as the index type. Then lower index, upper index, and then addresses. So this is the descriptor of single dimension array. Now see, this is a multi-dimension array. So see, this is a multi-dimensional array. Then element type, what is the type of the array, what is the type of the index, number of dimension, because it is a multi-dimensional array. So number of dimensions, so if it is a matrix, so if it is a two-dimensional array, so two dimensions will be there. If it is a three-dimensional array, three dimensions will be there. Now see, at zeroth index means at zeroth row, what is the size? Then first row, what is the size? Second row, what is the size? Likewise, okay. At every row, what is the range? What is the other dimension of other? What is the value of the other indices? And at the end, address. So these are the attributes are mentioned in the. This is the descriptor for the multidimensional array. So in this way, different arrays are defined or used in multiple programming languages. So friends, I hope you like this video. If yes, then click on like, subscribe to the channel, and don't forget to press bell icon so that you will get notification of my next video. So stay connected. Thank you.